वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिटरमाइन सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ बेंजोइक एसिड एट रूम टेम्परेचर इनटू डिफरेंट सॉल्वेंट्स। सो रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर कंडक्टिंग दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट: केमिकल्स, बेंजोइक एसिड, देन एथिल अल्कोहल एंड बेंजीन। And you require to prepare 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide and phenolphthalein as an indicator. Apparatus: burette, pipette, conical flask, then stirrer and beakers. So before conducting experiment, we'll see some theoretical concepts behind this experiment. So solubility is related with the solute and solvent, and then you will get a solution. So what exactly is solute? Solute is a component which dissolved in the solvent present in a less amount into the solution, while solvent is a component in which solute is dissolved and present in a more amount as compared to your solute. Then solution: a system in which solute are completely dissolved in a solvent and form a homogeneous dispersion, and that system is nothing but your solution system. Then saturated solution. For conducting this experiment, we required to prepare a saturated solution. Now what exactly is saturated solution? Is a one in which an equilibrium is established between dissolved and undissolved solute at a definite temperature, or a solution that contain a maximum amount of solute at a definite temperature. When you add excess amount of your drug or substance into the solvent, then excess amount remain as it is in the form of solid in your solution, and then you will come to know that you are ready with your saturated solution. Then unsaturated solution is a one containing dissolved solute in a concentration below that necessary for complete saturation at a definite temperature. Means concentration less than your saturated concentration when you add in your solvent, then the final solution is known as unsaturated solution. Then supersaturated solution contains more of dissolved solute than it would be normally contained into the saturated solution at particular temperature. Then we'll discuss what exactly the solubility, how it is expressed in a quantitative way and qualitative way. First of all, we'll discuss what is quantitative solubility. A concentration of solute in a saturated solution at a certain temperature, means how much amount of your solute entered in your solution, how much when your solution is saturated, then that amount of concentration of solute is nothing but your solubility, means how much maximum amount of solute can be incorporated in that particular solvent. This is your quantitative solubility. Then when you define this solubility in qualitative way, then we can say that the spontaneous interaction of two or more substances to form a homogeneous molecular dispersion. Okay, if you define this qualitatively, there is an interaction between your solute and solvent molecules, and then you will get a homogeneous solution form. Then solubility is an intrinsic material property that can be altered only by chemical modification of the molecule. Means if chemical modification is there, then only you will get a change into the concentration or change into the solubility of your solvent. Now we'll see a solubility expression terms. So solubility is expressed into the three into this different manner, that is molarity, moles, how much moles of solute in present into the 1 liter of solution, then molality, how much moles of solutes are there into the 1000 gram of solvent, then normality, gram equivalent weight of solute present into the 1 liter of solution, then mole fraction, it is represented by x, and it is a ratio of moles of solute to total number of solute and solvent present into the system. Then percent by weight, a gram of solute in 100 gram of solution. Then percent by volume, ml of solute in 100 ml of your solution. Is both the term that is both the thing, that is solute and solvent, you have to take measure into the ml, and here you have to measure into the gram. Percent wet in volume, here you have to measure your solute into the gram and measure your solvent into the ml. That's why it is percent wet by volume. The solubility of drug may be expressed in a number of ways, as we have discussed in above part. So as per USP, a solubility of drugs as a part of solvent required for one part of solute. USP describes a solubility using a 7 groups listed into the table given into the next slide. Solubility is also quantitatively expressed in terms of molarity and percentage. So this is solubility expression as per USP. When you have one part of your solute with you, how much part of solvent is required, and depending on these different descriptions or different classes of solubilities are there. So if you have one part of solute and if you required less than one part of solvent to dissolve it, then it is known as very soluble. For your one part of solute, if you required 1 to 10 part of your solvent, then it is known as poorly soluble. Similarly, if you require 10 to 30 part of your solvent, then it is known as soluble term. If you require 30 to 100 part of your solvent, then it is sparingly soluble. If you require 100 to 1000 part of your solvent, then it is slightly soluble into your solvent. Then if 1000 to 10,000 part of solvent is required to dissolve your one part of solute, then it is very slightly soluble. And if more than 10,000 part of solvent is required, then it is practically insoluble. Means we can say that your solute is insoluble into that particular solvent. So these are the different solubility expressions. Now we'll see exact procedure. So first of all, you have to prepare a saturated solution of benzoic acid in distilled water and into the ethanol. So you have to take these two solvents. First is your distilled water, second is your ethanol. Then you have to add excess amount of your benzoic acid. Slowly you have to add benzoic acid into these two solvents, and you have to prepare saturated solution of benzoic acid into these two solvents. Then you have to filter this solution and collect that filtrate into dry air clean beaker. So collect all filtrate separately. A filtrate obtained from saturated solution of your benzoic acid in water, you have to collect 1 ml of filtrate and you have to add 10 ml of water in that filtrate, and you have to titrate it by using 0.1 normal NaOH and phenolphthalein as an indicator. Similarly, you have to collect 1 ml filtrate of saturated solution of your benzoic acid into ethanol, and you have to take 1 ml of that filtrate and 10 ml water and titrate it against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide using phenolphthalein as an indicator. Now when you titrate it with the help of this phenolphthalein as an indicator, your end point will be a light pink color. Okay, when you obtain light pink color after titration, then you have to stop and take a burette reading. So for a single filtrate, either it is a filtrate into the distilled water or ethanol, for this single filtrate we have to take three readings, and you have to take an average of these three reading and then consider this reading for the calculation. Okay, now we'll see actual practical demonstration how to conduct this experiment. Practical demonstration how to determine solubility of benzoic acid in different solvent. For this experiment we'll require burette stand, burette, then this filtration assembly, measuring cylinder and labeled beaker and glass rock. Then chemicals required to conduct this experiment: this ethanol, then distilled water, then 0.1 normal NaOH and benzoic acid. So I am going to prepare a saturated solution of benzoic acid in distilled water. First of all, I am going to take a 10 ml of Now I am going to prepare a saturated solution of benzoic acid. Here in this beaker I have taken 20 ml of distilled water. Now slowly I am going to add benzoic acid in this distilled water. And it is dissolving. When your solution is clear, then you have to add a further amount of this benzoic acid. Likewise, slowly you have to add this benzoic acid. And after addition of certain amount of this benzoic acid, you will get a solid form of this benzoic acid as it is in this solution. Then you will come to know that this is a saturation point. So this all distilled water gets saturated, and remaining amount of benzoic acid remain as it is. If you observe it, benzoic acid is seen at the bottom of your beaker. So here it is a saturated solution ready for the experiment. Similarly, I have taken a 20 ml of ethanol in this beaker, and slowly I am going to add benzoic acid in this ethanol, and this benzoic acid is going to solubilize into this ethanol. You have to check it vigorously with help of glass rod and add further more amount of your benzoic acid into the solvent. Now we are ready with
both the saturated solution, saturated solution of benzoic acid in water as well as saturated solution of benzoic acid in ethanol. If you observe the bottom of this beaker, some benzoic acid is there, it means that your saturated solution is ready. Similarly, benzoic acid is there at the bottom of beaker, so benzoic acid is saturated solution of benzoic acid into this solvent is ready. Now we are ready with these two solvents. Now we'll filter it. Now I am going to filter this saturated solution of benzoic acid. You have to collect this filter, then you have to dilute it and then titrate it with the 0.1 normal NaOH. Now we are ready with a filtrate of saturated solution of benzoic acid into the ethanol. So keep it aside, then we are going to filter the saturated solution of benzoic acid into the water. So for this we require to change this filter paper. So I am going to filter the saturated solution of benzoic acid and distilled water. Similar way, you have to collect this filtrate, you have to dilute it with water and titrate with the help of 0.1 normal NaOH. So again I am ready with my second filtrate. Then I am going to dilute it and I will titrate it against 0.2 normal NaOH. In this conical flask, I have taken 1 ml filtrate of ethanol and 10 ml distilled water. Now, total volume present in this volumetric flask, it is 11 ml. Now, I have added 2 drops of phenolphthalein in this conical flask and then I am going to titrate it. Dropwise addition should be there. Shake your conical flask after addition of this NaOH. Now I have finished with this titration. Now my burette reading is 15.7. Now likewise I am going to take 3 readings for this ethanol filtrate. Now in this conical flask I have taken 1 ml of filtrate of benzoic acid into the distilled water and then I have added 2-3 drops of phenolphthalein. Now I am going to titrate it. Slowly, slowly you have to add. Now this colorless solution is finished with titration because my colorless solution is converted into the light pink color solution and my burette reading is 0.6 ml. So likewise, I am going to take 3 readings of these filtrate of benzoic acid prepared into the distilled water and similarly I have taken 3 readings for the filtrate of this benzoic acid which is prepared into the ethanol. So now we'll see.
Then your observation table will be like this, solution and your burette reading. Solution represents a filtrate of your saturated solution of benzoic acid in water and it is diluted with 10 ml of your water and then titrated against the 0.1 normal NaOH. So readings obtained for with filtrate of benzoic acid into the water, and that is 15.7, 16.3 and 16.5. So average is 16.2. Similarly, readings obtained by titrating this saturated solution of benzoic acid in alcohol, that is 0.6, 0.8 and 0.9 ml. So average of all these three reading is 0.8 ml. First of all, we'll calculate a normality of that solution, and then we'll calculate solubility of the drug or benzoic acid into the different solvent. Now, how can we calculate this normality? Simply, it is calculated by using N1V1 is equal to N2V2 formula. So, N1V1 represents normality of your benzoic acid and how much volume of benzoic acid you have taken, while N2V2 normality of your sodium hydroxide and how much volume of sodium hydroxide required to neutralize that benzoic acid. Okay, it is represented by V2. Then we don't know a normality of benzoic acid, that is N1 value, but we known about how much volume of your benzoic acid we have taken for the titration. 1 ml of your filtrate plus 10 ml of your distilled water, so volume is 11 ml. Then normality of sodium hydroxide, that is 0.1 normal, and V2 represents burette reading. So this V2 value for water we have obtained, that is 0.8 ml. This is the average burette reading of your saturated solution of benzoic acid in water. So I just put this value into this equation, that is 0.1 into V2 divided by 11, and this V2 value is 0.8 ml. So my final answer is 0.0072 normal. So now normality of these solution is 0.072. Then I am going to calculate how much drug is solubilized per ml of your solvent. Now A into gram equivalent weight of benzoic acid present into the 1000 ml. So I want to calculate it into gram per ml. For this purpose, you have to use this formula: A into molecular weight of your drug, that is benzoic acid, divided by 1000. So the value of A is 0.0072. I have just put this value in this equation, and my final answer is 0.00088 gram per ml. So this is a solubility of benzoic acid in water at a room temperature. Then we'll see a solubility of benzoic acid in ethanol at a room temperature. Similarly, you have to calculate normality of your solution and then move ahead to determine solubility of drug gram per ml. So first of all, I am going to calculate normality of solution, that is benzoic acid is equal to sodium hydroxide. This N1V1 value you have to consider regarding benzoic acid, and N2V2 value you have to consider regarding your sodium hydroxide. So again N1 we want to calculate, and amount of your benzoic acid in ml is 11 ml. अब इट इज 11 ml, 1 ml ऑफ योर फिल्ट्रेट एंड 10 ml ऑफ योर डिस्टिल वाटर. देन नॉर्मेलिटी ऑफ सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड इज 0.1 नॉर्मल एंड V2 इज ब्यूरेट रीडिंग N1 इज इक्वल टू 0.1 इंटू V2 डिवाइडेड बाय 11. सो एवरेज ब्यूरेट रीडिंग इज 16.2. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ योर V2 वैल्यू यू हैव टू पुट 16.2. देन फाइनल आंसर इज 0.15 नॉर्मल. नॉर्मेलिटी ऑफ बेंजोइक एसिड इन इथेनॉल इज 0.15 नॉर्मल. देन आई एम गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट अ सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ बेंजोइक एसिड इन टू इथेनॉल. ए इंटू ग्राम इक्विवेलेंट वेट ऑफ बेंजोइक एसिड प्रेजेंट इन टू द 1000 ml ऑफ सॉल्वेंट. देन ए इंटू 122.12 डिवाइडेड बाय 1000. वैल्यू ऑफ ए इज 0.15 एंड 122.12 इज अ मॉलिकुलर वेट ऑफ योर बेंजोइक एसिड. देन माई फाइनल आंसर इज 0.01832 ग्राम पर ml. रिजल्ट द सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ बेंजोइक एसिड इन वॉटर इज 0.00088 ग्राम पर ml एंड सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ बेंजोइक एसिड इन अल्कोहल इज 0.01832 ग्राम पर ml. नाउ विल सी क्वेश्चंस दैट विल बी आस्क्ड इन योर सिनॉप्सिस. First question, define solubility and solution. Okay, solubility is defined into two terms, that is quantitative term and qualitative term. So when we are defining solubility in quantitative term, as a concentration of solute in a saturated solution at a certain temperature, then definition of solubility in qualitative way as a homogeneous spontaneous interaction of two or more substances to form a homogeneous molecular dispersion. Then solution, a system in which solute are completely dissolved in a solvent and form homogeneous molecular dispersion, and it is known as solution. Then second question, what are saturated, unsaturated and supersaturated solutions? So saturated solution is one in which an equilibrium is established between dissolved and undissolved solute at a definite temperature, or a solution that contain the maximum amount of solute at a definite temperature. Unsaturated solution is one containing the dissolved solute in a concentration below to that necessary for complete saturation at a definite temperature. Then supersaturated solution, it contains more of dissolved solute than it would normally contain in a saturated state at a definite temperature. Define molarity, molality and normality. So molarity or molar concentration is number of moles of solute per liter of your solution. And this can be calculated by using formula molarity is equal to mole of solute per liter of your solution. Then molality is a measure of amount of solute in a solution in terms of amount of substance in a specified amount of mass of solvent. That is molality. In case of molarity, we are taking your solvent into the liter, but in case of molality, we are taking a solvent in terms of mass. Then normality is described as the number of grams or mole equivalents of solute present in 1 liter of solution. When we say equivalent, it is that number of moles of reactive unit in a compound. Then give a solubility expression as per USP. So this is solubility expression as per USP. If one part of your solute required one part of solvent, then it is known as very soluble. But if 1 to 10 part is required, then it is poorly soluble. When 10 to 30 part is required to solubilize one part of your solute, then it is soluble. If 30 to 100 part is required of your solvent, then it is sparingly soluble. Then 100 to 1000 part of your solvent is required to solubilize one part of your solvent, then it is slightly soluble. Likewise, if 1000 to 10,000 part is required of your solvent for one part of solute, then it is very slightly soluble. And if you require more than 10,000 part of your solvent for solubilization of one part of your solute, then it is practically insoluble. Then next question, what is co-solvent? A co-solvent is a substance that is added to a mixture of two or more separate substances that are typically immiscible. And in order to make them mixable or miscible by addition of this co-solvent. And co-solvents are added to increase a solvent power of a primary substance into the mixture. So these co-solvents are added to enhance or to make a immiscible liquid miscible by using this co-solvents. This is all about determination of solubility of benzoic acid at room temperature. Thank you.